CO₂ is converted into clean power by prototype nanogenerator. In order to generate power, researchers have constructed a generator that collects carbon dioxide, or CO₂. The tiny proof-of-concept nanogenerator consumes the greenhouse gas, making it carbon negative, according to the Center for Sustainable Engineering Innovation. The two parts of this nanogenerator are a polyamine gel, which is already utilized by industry to absorb CO₂, and a skeleton of boron nitride, which is only a few atoms thick and produces both positive and negative ions. Because the different sizes of the positive ions travel at varying speeds, scientists were able to make them considerably larger than the negative ions. This created a diffusion current that could be amplified into energy to power light bulbs or any other electronic device. Ion transport is the most effective energy conversion in nature and the human body. It is even more effective than electron transport, which is employed in the power grid. The two halves were sliced into 4-centimeter discs and tiny rectangles, implanted in a 90% water hydrogel, and tested in an enclosed chamber filled with CO₂. They were concerned that something had gone wrong when they noticed electrical impulses emanating. After making sure everything was functioning properly, they began to envision how this technology may be used to change the world. In addition to being carbon neutral, this technology uses CO₂ in the process of producing electricity. They can now capture around 1% of the energy carried by gas CO₂ intrinsically, but like other technologies, they will now focus on increasing efficiency and cutting costs. In light of the laboratory experiment's success, the nanogenerator may find use in two future applications. They could develop a somewhat bigger portable device that could generate electricity to power a mobile phone or laptop computer using CO₂ from the atmosphere. In a second, far more extensive use, this technology would be used in conjunction with an industrial CO₂ collecting operation to produce electricity. The Center of Excellence for Green Electrochemical Transformation of Carbon Dioxide will continue to develop the nanogenerator under the guidance of the School of Chemical Engineering. They wish to change the perception of CO₂ since they recognize the advantages of a problematic greenhouse gas. Although CO₂ has been seen as a problem that needs to be remedied, it could also turn out to be a resource in the future. Credit: University of Queensland. How can a nanogenerator turn CO₂ into electricity? A nanogenerator that turns CO₂ into electricity leverages nanotechnology and chemical processes to convert carbon dioxide into energy through innovative mechanisms. While this concept is still largely experimental, it builds on known principles of electrochemical and catalytic conversion, utilizing CO₂ as a feedstock in energy-generating reactions. Here's how it might work in detail. 1. The role of CO₂. CO₂ is a resource. Carbon dioxide is a stable molecule, but under the right conditions, it can be broken down into its components, carbon and oxygen, or converted into other molecules like carbon monoxide, CO, or methanol. This process releases energy or creates intermediates that can be used for generating electricity. Why nanotechnology? Nanotechnology enables the manipulation of materials at the atomic or molecular scale, providing a higher surface area, enhanced reactivity, and improved efficiency in chemical reactions involving CO₂. 2. Mechanisms to convert CO₂ to electricity. There are a few ways nanogenerators might use CO₂ to generate electricity. CO₂ electrochemical conversion. Nanostructured electrodes. Electrochemical cells equipped with nanomaterials, e.g., graphene, transition metal oxides, or perovskites, act as catalysts. These materials can break down CO₂ when an electropotential is applied. The nanostructures enhance the surface area and reaction rates, improving efficiency. Reaction process. CO₂ is introduced into an electrolyte. A catalyst on the nanostructured electrode reduces CO₂ into high-energy products like CO or formic acid. Electrons released in these reactions generate an electrical current. Electricity generation. The flow of electrons is harnessed to power a circuit, converting chemical energy into electrical energy. CO₂ adsorption and piezoelectric conversion. Adsorption of CO₂. Certain nanomaterials, e.g. metal organic frameworks or MOFs, can adsorb CO₂ from the air or other sources due to their porous structures. When CO₂ molecules interact with these materials, they create localized stresses or changes in electronic properties. Piezoelectric effect. Some nanomaterials exhibit piezoelectric properties, generating electric charges in response to mechanical stress or molecular interactions. CO₂ adsorption and desorption cycles create mechanical deformations that generate electricity through this effect. See photoelectrochemical conversion. Nanophotocatalysts. Nanomaterials like titanium dioxide, TO₂, or graphene are used to harvest light energy to drive the reduction of CO₂. Sunlight activates the nanophotocatalyst, creating electron-hole pairs that participate in converting CO₂ into energy-rich compounds like methane or methanol. Energy output. The chemical energy stored in the products can be used to generate electricity in a secondary process, such as combustion in fuel cells. Three example systems. Direct CO₂ nanogenerator. A prototype might consist of a CO₂ adsorption layer using MOFs or other nanomaterials, an integrated catalytic layer that facilitates CO₂ reduction, a piezoelectric or electrochemical system that captures and converts the reaction energy into electricity. Hybrid nanogenerator combines photoelectrochemical and electrochemical systems. Sunlight powers the photochemical conversion of CO₂. Electrons generated from this reaction flow through a circuit, generating electricity. Four potential applications: carbon capture and energy production. Convert CO₂ emissions from factories and power plants into usable energy. Decentralized energy systems. Deploy nanogenerators in remote or urban areas to capture CO₂ from the atmosphere and generate power locally. Sustainability goals. Such systems align with carbon neutral initiatives, turning a greenhouse gas into a resource for renewable energy. Five challenges. Energy input versus output. Breaking down CO₂ requires significant energy due to its chemical stability. To make the system efficient, nanogenerators must minimize energy input or use renewable sources like sunlight. Scaling up. Current technologies are mostly lab scale and need advancements to be viable for large-scale deployment. Cost and durability. Nanomaterials can be expensive and may degrade over time, posing economic and practical challenges. Six outlook. While the concept of a nanogenerator turning CO₂ into electricity is still emerging, advancements in nanotechnology, material science, and renewable energy could make it a transformative tool. With ongoing research, these devices could provide a sustainable way to address climate change by reducing atmospheric CO₂ while simultaneously generating green energy.